Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1737. Hide blank rows without having to remember to run a macro. Hey, welcome back. This is deja vu from 1736. It turns out that Kathy wasn't really opposed to macros. She was just opposed to having to remember to run the macro. So it wanted to be automatic, and I offered something called an event handler macro that would hide the blank rows in this box. So anything here in this box is going to get hidden automatically. Now, a couple of things. I noticed that Kathy's file was an xlsx, so we're going to have to do file, save as, and save this as macro enabled. Otherwise, the macro won't be allowed to run, so we'll have to do that. And then, you also have to check your tools macro security, which I do Alt-T-M-S. There is, of course, a better way to do that through file options and trust center, yada, yada, yada. Make sure that you're not here at disable all macros without notification. You want to go to the second one where they notify you that they're going to disable macros. That allows you to turn them back on. So we're going to do those two things. The other huge problem that we have with a macro is going to be hard-coded to look at rows 16 through 24, and as someone deletes a row here or inserts a row here, the macro is not going to work anymore. So stealthily, before I do this, I selected that range and name that range. I'll just call it, check range or something like that. All right, so now there's a named range, and I know in the macro that we want to check all the cells in checked range. All right, so here we go. We're in podcast 1737.xlsm. I'll press Alt F11. That will get us to VBA. If you can't see the Project Explorer, we do View, Project Explorer, or Control R. Find the episode, or the workbook, Podcast 1737, and we're going to go to the sheet that has the data and double click. From the top left drop down, choose Worksheet. It's the only thing to choose. They choose Selection Change. I'm going to change it to be, we could do Calculate, we could do Change. Let's do Change. That way, every time that someone changes the worksheet, this macro will run. All right, and what are we going to do? We're going to say for each cell in range, what was it called? Check range. That has to correspond to the name that you just created back in the sheet, next cell. And we're going to say, we want to check to see if that is filled in. And in this case, it was numeric. So we can say if application.worksheet function dot is number. They don't have is blank in here. It's a little annoying. Is number cell. Then, so if there's a number there, we want to keep that row visible. So we say cell dot entire row dot hidden equals false. Otherwise, if there's not a number there, then cell dot entire row dot hidden equals true. And if so, that's the code right there. All right, so worksheet change. Yep, we can even do debug compile, make sure I didn't spell anything wrong. All right, we'll go back here to Excel. And the way that this works, you see that it didn't automatically hide things because I haven't changed the worksheet. So I just have to come to any blank cell, type the number one, and bang, right there, it's hidden. All right, now we're going to have the exact same problem that we had yesterday in episode 1736. What if I need to fill in something? We're going to use go to. All right, so Control G or F5 will display the go to dialog box, and I can go to that hidden cell. So in this case, C19 is where a blank is. So I'll go to C19. I've actually selected C19, although I can't see it, and I can type the new number 123456. When I press enter, the macro runs again and it unhides. Isn't that a cool trick? All right, so it's kind of a hassle to get in there and unhide. I guess you could always do Alt ORU, format row unhide, and then type the new number and press enter, and it'll go through and unhide the unused ones, although that frankly would annoy the heck out of me. So this tiny little event handler macro, it's not running in a module, it's actually on the sheet, worksheet change, will go through and hide the cells that are not currently filled in with a number. Well, hey, I want to thank Kathy for sending that question in, and I want to thank Kathy for allowing me to use some VBA as long as it was in event handler. thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.